Very good evening to all of you, ladies and gentlemen. It's my profound pleasure to welcome you all to this second AgriBusiness Awards instituted by Media Today. I have known Mr. Naqvi for more than 25 years. A very good initiative that has been taken by him is to institute this AgriBusiness Award to recognize professionals, recognize people who have taken initiatives in promoting agriculture and agribusiness. The great work being done by the people must be recognized. It motivates people, it makes progress for the country, and gives recognition to India on this globe. So with these words, once again, I welcome all of you to this second AgriBusiness Awards.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It's my privilege to attend this award ceremony for the second year. First of all, I would like to congratulate Indian Conventions, the organizers of the ceremony, as well as Media Today Group for persisting with this. I think it's a service they are doing to the food industry, to the agri value chain industry, and everyone who is engaged in it. Farming is not only a service, but it's also a business, and he and his family have to live by it. Therefore, our effort should be to convert agriculture into agribusiness. That's why those who have succeeded in doing so, we should recognize their efforts so that others can follow. And I'm very glad that today we are going to honor few of the leaders who have succeeded, who have innovated, and through their perseverance and intellectual ability, they have come up and they are now shining examples for all of you. I am very grateful to my colleagues in the jury who unanimously have, each and every person has been very thoroughly scrutinized. Their suitability has been judged, and we have been unanimous in selecting them. Thank you very much.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm a head of AgriHub. It's an initiative in Brazil that connects the farmers with startups to make the field and the farmers more profitable. It's a pleasure to be here with you today. And I want to congratulate the organizers of this event, the Indian farmers, and the agribusiness company here. We are impressed with you and what we see here in this week. And I hope to come back soon to this friendly country.
Namaskar. Thank you to the organizers for giving me this opportunity to share some of the thoughts with you all. Friends, we are in business of food. And very often I say that this is not a business of food, we are in a business of trust. Opportunity is huge. I'm talking of 1.3 billion population. Today we are producing something about 650 million tons of food items. By 2030, our requirement is going to be something about 1200 million tons of food. I'm just talking of human food. This 1.3 million population of livestock, I have not even calculated that. They also need food. Then you have an industrial application. 5,000 industries depend on agro-based raw material for their existence. That's another requirement. So considering all these complex scenario on one side and a huge emerging opportunity on the other side, if you are not going to put your house in order, I can only tell you, customer will get food. You may not get the market. It's time to change. Think about it. I wish you all the best. Have a great time. Thank you.
To have further discussion on this, let me invite people who have practiced these kinds of areas, who have observed gaps, to the dais for a brief panel discussion. Let me invite Mr. S.N. Patil, Head of Department from Jain Irrigation, Mr. Bijan Mishra, Founder Consumer Online Foundation, Mr. Gautam Sharma, Managing Director of Indonesian. Mr. Patil, I would like to start with you. We have heard certain success stories in the case of grapes, as you might have also heard, in pomegranates, in certain other horticulture crops. But you have successfully practiced it for several years. So would you like to tell the audience what have been the top five components of the initiative taken by you?
First of all, you need to maintain the records for all the things. Now there are the systems. Once you apply for the standard ISO, it's a ISO is given for the system process. From there, we started the things. Then, one by one, the things are going to be added, one by one. Whatever the problems you face in the past and what is the requirement of future. So in that way, then providing the trainings to the employees. By providing the trainings to the consumers and also. Once we apply the practices in your day-to-day working, the things will come up.
So what you essentially said was that you started working with the farmers, guiding them on the best practices, and also associating the practices with the consumer requirements.
Yes.
So this was in the forefront of your mind to meet that demand.
Yes.
Mr. Sharma, Mr. Gautam Sharma, you are producing products which are multi-ingredients, whether it is a fruit or a vegetable, either in dried form or wet form, or spices or other ingredients, or even additives where you need. How have you implemented farm-to-fork practices in such a complex situation?
Just like technology is being used at the producer end of agriculture, we are using a lot of technology at our manufacturing end. And for example, in our cup noodles product, so you know, we take a physical picture of each cup. So in terms of traceability, in theory, we can, if a particular cup, something is there and the consumer complains, we can take a look at the picture. Yeah. And then we do a lot of back-end quality process development with each of our partners and suppliers.
So a very a common thing that has emerged from the interventions of both the panel members is that training and awareness, both are important, and both of them have said the same thing eventually. So my question to you, Mr. Bijan Mishra, you are the voice of the consumers. According to you, when it comes to the manufacturers or suppliers of food products, what are the gaps that you have observed in your analysis?
Friends, my simple understanding is to all both my friends and people from the industry. You have to develop a kind of a relationship with the consumer. And the relationship means bade gehri samman, not upar ka samman. Each producer or each manufacturer of food business especially should know each one of the consumer who is using your product. Very, very important. It is a consumer who is paying, but the poor consumer does not come to know, am I getting the right quality or not? So what does the consumers feel most happy about? They feel very happy when you say that this is Mr. Goswami's standard or Mr. Sharma's standard or whatever standard, but it is some standard you talk about. Number two, the consumer is very happy when you speak in the language they want, not in the language you want. If I am a Kannada person, please stop talking to me in English and writing labels in English. For heaven's sake, write the labels in my language which I can read and I can understand. The third most important thing is, how transparent I am. Can I go to the website and understand that what has been your whole journey from farm to the fork, will you be able to explain to me in a very simple language if I go to the website? Hum in brief ye kehna chahenge ki hum bade khush hote hain us logo se jo food jo hamare roz ka khane ka samaan hai wo swachhta ke sath sahi keemat ke sath sahi dhang se hamare ghar tak pahuncha de us dhang se pahunchaye jis dhang se hum chahte hain. And that is what is the key, because we make the payment, we take all the expenses, so please, sometimes come to our side, listen to our story, sometimes take our feedback, and sometimes what you did with our feedback, tell us. So this is what, in brief, I would like to say, palm to the fork means a seamless exercise, an exercise which is without any barriers, without any discrimination, without any color and creed, without any profile in terms of rich and poor, it is reached to the people in the manner it should be reached to everybody in this world or in this country.
Thank you, Mr. Gavi. And I thank all the panelists to come over and making this happen. I now call upon Mr. Talees Rizvi and Mr. M.B. Nakhvi to come over to present a memento to Mr. Vijay Sardana, who has been a part of the jury as well.
I will now speak about the water resources and food security. Water security is vital for the sustenance of living beings, food production and economic development. Increasing storage is essential for water security. Food security is an essential part and dependent on water security. We need to increase the water productivity of crop, both in respect of land as well as water. Adoption of modern practices of irrigation and agriculture. So, har khet ko pani and more crop per drop, which are the slogans of the Prime Minister, they are imperative for enhancing farmers' income. Thank you very much. I'll just conclude with another couplet, so to make it a little warm and enlightening. Shikwaye zulmate shab se to kahin behtar hai. Raat ke andhere ki shikayat karne se to ye kahin behtar hai. Apne hisse ki koi shama jalate chaliye. Thank you very much.
I request Mr. Mohammed Ashfaq Qureshi, Chef and CEO, Shaheen F&B Consultants, to come over to the dais.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. The dhabas, the new dhabas which are going to come up, are going to be state of the art. So I request all the technical people and the farmer community to produce for such thing, whether the food from Assam or Sikkim or let's say Rajasthan, they will be in demand very soon in terms of a retail outlet. Health related foods, for example, vegan food, food related to high protein diet, and such requirements are going to be extensively required. New world cuisines. We have seen a delegation from Brazil. I am 100% excited to have a Brazilian restaurant. As a chef, I understand that there is technologist and there is a farmer. And in between somewhere, we are the food developers. We need your help. We need your guidance. And of course, the local government, the government of India, which needs to support us. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Mr. Qureshi. Before we move on to the award ceremony, we would actually like to recognize the jury members. The time for the award ceremony. And the first award goes to for their contribution towards the frozen foods, Vista Processed Foods Private Limited.
I would like to thank the jury for giving us award in the frozen food category and the Indian Convention award, which is by the AgriBusiness Excellency. It motivates the frozen industry to grow in India.
Thank you for collecting this award. And the next one goes to Arctic Refrigeration Private Limited for their refrigeration technology. And the next award goes to
Karimnagar Milk Producer Company for their milk and milk products. And the next award goes to Suguna Foods Private Limited for their integrated value chain of poultry. The next award goes to Nissin Foods for their instant food management. And the next award goes to ITC Limited for their efforts towards digitalization of agri value chain. And the next award, this one goes to GujPro AgriBusiness, a producer company limited, for their quality assurance of farm products.
This company is owned by 35 FPOs in Gujarat, means 40,000 farmers. So this award, it is really recognition not only for GujPro, but also for 40,000 farmers. We dedicate this award to Government of Gujarat. They have very much supportive to GujPro. This is a new responsibility for us because we have received this award for quality of farm products which we need to maintain.
And this award for women agripreneurship goes to Hybrid Agri Biotech Private Limited. And the next award, Miltech Machinery Private Limited. This one goes for their grain processing machineries.
It was a great evening. Thank you very much for the Business Excellence Award for Best Equipment Manufacturer from Media Today and India Convention. I think it's also a hallmark of a company which is growing and doing well in the agribusiness.
So we move on to the next AgriBusiness Excellence Awards 2018. Stellabs Technologies Private Limited.
Yeah, it was a great show. I'm really glad and honored to receive the award on behalf of Stellabs Technologies Private Limited. And we are providing IoT-based solutions to dairy sector in agri vertical. So I'm really glad, and this award really motivates all of our team, Stellabs team.
This one goes to Chain Irrigation Systems Private Limited for their innovations in the irrigation technology.
It's a good event and good initiative taken by Media Today Group. It's a nice recognition made based on the merits and work done for the different industries.
And this one goes for their tissue culture. This award goes to KF Bioplants Private Limited. The next one goes for their cold chain logistics, Crystal Logistic Cold Chain Limited.
Thank you, Mr. Gokul Patnaik ji. Thank you, jury, and thank you all the team member here present. बहुत बढ़िया लगा मेरे को award मिलके, and industry ने मेरे को बहुत कुछ दिया है, and मैं अपनी तरफ से भी कुछ देना चाहता हूँ अगर मेरे को मौका मिलेगा. Thank you.
And the next Indian Agribusiness Excellence Award goes to Grain Storage, and this one is backed by Misilio Turkey.
First of all, thank you very much to jury to an organizer. Actually, मैं तुर्की से हूँ, लेकिन पिछले चार सालों इंडिया में हूँ, and और मैं अपने आप का इंडियन फीलिंग करते हूँ. So I am very happy. Thank you very much for your supporting. धन्यवाद. जय हिंद.
And this one goes to the Chairman, Central Water Commission, Conservation of Water Resources, Mr. S. Masood Hussain. And the next one is a very big award. This one goes to Mr. and Dr. Imtiaz Qureshi. He's a Padma Shri, a brand ambassador of Indian culinary industry, a lifetime achievement award for professional excellence in culinary art.
बहुत हम शुक्रगुजार हैं कि जो लाइफ टाइम ये अवार्ड मिला है. अवार्ड तो बहुत मिल चुके हैं, बाकी इसको जो हमारी खुशी हुई है और हमारे दोस्तों को जो खुशी मिली है वो हम उसका इतने शुक्रगुजार हैं कि इसका हम बयान नहीं कर सकते.
The lifetime of achievement award which is given to my father, I'm really really thankful to HRC. He has got many awards in past, but this is probably one of the best awards that he has got, purely because it represents the larger industry, which is food and beverages, represents technologists, it represents cuisine curators, and also the farmers. Thank you so much.
With this, we come to the end of this award ceremony. Once again, I thank all of you, all the celebrity chefs, all the delegates, all the members. And of course, I must be a little bit selfish and take this opportunity to help to thank my team member, Media Today team, who have been working day and night to make this entire program a grand success. And of course, the team of Indian Conventions, who have been working for almost continuously for last 72 hours to chalk out every single minute detail of this program, and they have very successfully put in this in a success mode. With this, we can come to the end of it, and I request all of you to kindly join for the dinner.